Here we are getting ready to go hiking Sunday morning. And it's kind of cloudy. Beautiful for hiking weather.
Yeah.
Hi. How did it go?
It's good.
Yeah, great. Good weather, huh? This is just one of the many entrances into this part, this trail. And watch out, rattlesnakes. We have mountain lion. Wow. Dogs are not allowed. So which way are we going? This route?
This way.
All right.
That sounds fine. Oh,
but it's a steep hill. We're gonna go up there and then go down the canyon, right?
Yeah.
So here we go. Well, we saw the sign, dogs are not allowed, but obviously it's not enforced. So we are about a quarter mile, almost a half mile into the hike, and you can actually go over to the side and see Anaheim Hills on this. Oh, it's a cloudy day, so it's hard to see. Finish this hike. It's about 4.1 or 4.2 mile loop in about 80 minutes. And we started going on this trail since Tyler was what, 5 years old?
No.
Or maybe even 4 years old.
No.
And they were slow at that time. It took probably more than 2 hours to complete. But they're a lot faster now, right, kids? Yeah? Gonna finish in 80 minutes?
Yes. 80? Maybe 85
something. Hey, oh! Some people are doing some kind of a... Oh, like a drone kind of thing. Oh, cool. Hi! Wow, you gonna fly it?
Absolutely.
Oh, wow. It's kind of windy.
Yes, exactly.
That's why you need it? To be windy? Oh. It's like a glider then.
Oh.
Yeah.
You put a camera on it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I get some aerial
view. Yeah, I fly about.
He obviously has a remote control that will. Okay, so that's why.
So
alright, let's hope that we can see the planes up in the air in a little bit. Yeah, of course. Alright, so let's keep going. How are we feeling? Pretty good, huh? We're going downhill?
I don't.
Not yet. But it's only been 1 mile. See this during spring break? Sometimes in early April, late April. But this year, yes, because of all the warm weather and the rain that we have, all the surrounding hills are kind of green already.
Look,
and this is late February, February 22nd. So overall, this is a pretty easy hike, right, guys? Pretty easy. Just some slopes up and down, but otherwise, pretty wide trail. And guess what? The most common questions I get from friends is, what do we do when we need to go number one or number two on the trail? Ooh. Well, obviously there are no restrooms along the trails, am I right?
You have to dig a hole.
You have to dig a hole, that's one
solution.
You
have to dig a hole. Bring a water bottle or some sanitizer.
Okay, that's how you wash your hands.
Which I have right here.
Okay, very good. Come prepared.
Or actually, sometimes people bring those, like, little baby toilets to bring along on a hiking trail.
You mean diapers?
No.
Those will be the baby toilets.
No?
You mean like a
three-year-old
toilet?
Like a mini pod.
Oh, okay. Well, I haven't seen one, but that's one of the solutions. But, well, you just find a bush and dig a hole. That's how it's done out in the woods. The old-fashioned way, that's
it. Toilets were invented.
Oh, I guess.
What? Toilets weren't actually invented until 1930-something.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I see.
I read it in a dictionary.
Is that right?
Yeah,
19-something. The modern toilet you're talking about, right?
Before that, there's only like wooden toilets and stuff.
Uh-huh. And usually there would be...
And normally it would just be like
a
square shape and then a hole in the
middle. Uh-huh.
And then you just have to put plastic in.
I see. So what happened to the stuff that go down there for that hole? You know, in the Middle Ages... You don't want to know. Okay.
Yeah.
Alright, so let's stop from that. Okay, no more. Let's get away from that.
Unless it's the part where it goes into the drains and stuff.
Uh-huh. Okay. Never mind. Move on. The park is really big. You can go for as little as a few miles, or I think it's as long as 17 miles. All the way from, I think, Freeway 57 over there. I don't know how far in there, we haven't explored yet. So there's the split, and that's where we're gonna go down. Very good. And since we only have time to complete this 4-mile loop, we're gonna go this way. Keep on going. Are you guys enjoying the hikes? Tell me, how you feel? Okay?
Me.
Nope, not tired. Very good. So there, the canyon trail. I see horse shoes on the trail. Normally there are a lot of bicyclists. We probably started a little late today, and we haven't seen any. We'll see some on the way. So here it is, the Telegraph Canyon Trail. And oh, here comes the family. And we're gonna head that way back to where we started. We are officially at the midway point after 4 miles, 2 miles so far. And 40 minutes, just about. And from here, it's all flat. So, past years, there was some little creeks that run across this trail, right?
But it's hot now.
And because of the drought, we haven't seen the creeks in the past 2-3 time that we went. There's a lot of poops. Must be from the horses. There's some more poop alert. So, we're taking a little break, because we saw something interesting. Tyler, tell me what this is. Lana?
It's poison oak.
What is it?
Poison oak.
That is poison oaks. So what do you do?
Creek right here.
There used to be a creek. No, there was no creek, but it's wet. It's been wet, so...
It's wet down there.
So these plants have been growing. How do you know it's poison oaks?
Because there's three leaves.
Three leaves.
In like a close.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And what does it do to you?
It's poisonous. So
poisonous?
It's like it gives you itch.
Itch. Very itchy if you touch it. So you see it,
one
stay away.
You're
gonna get rash. How we doing?
Good.
A little tired? Not so much? Okay. Have some. Have some more. About a mile and a half to go. So this was used to be one of those four creeks. Now it's completely dry. Well, there are. Poison oaks are right there. There. And these. Don't touch.
This used to be a creek right here.
Used to be a creek right here.
Carry the kids across.
Yeah. Used to be quite a bit of water.
Near the creek, you have
poison oak. So there, show you that there's a real drought in California. Real drought. Please conserve water.
What smells so bad?
Must be the mud. So this used to be one of four little creeks that ran across, and this is what we have left.
One.
Only one. And we're gonna have to make it across. So here we go. Follow my way. Let me feel it. Solid. Pretty solid. Pretty solid. Okay. Very good. Good job. Come on, Lana. Right here. And obviously, poison oaks. Big giant one. Oh, how about that? Tumbleweed in the middle. So we got to see some birds. So we are about maybe less than a half a mile left. That is the sign. A very narrow, small trail that goes back to where we started, just over that ridge. Right over there in the middle, right there. And it's about a quarter mile. Here we go. There used to be water in this creek too, a lot of water. Now it's completely dry. Start seeing the houses where we started. Right over there.
So, I see the houses.
Yep. We're almost back. And we made it back at the mark of 82 minutes. We started that way. Went up that way and we went back on that route. Now there's another shorter loop, you can go that way, and it's about 2.5 miles. Go that way, go down, and still go back. So we came in from Rimcrest in Yorba Linda.